Shalom Israel, this is Bishop Nathaniel. The Israelites have been scattered across the four corners of the earth, as prophesied in Deuteronomy, the 28th chapter. Here in Israel, united in Christ, we need your help to recover the remnant of our people, teach them the gospel. Please help us, support us, and join or donate to the Booster Club today. Shalom.
Matthew chapter 15 and verse 27. This is what's going to set our people in order. But look what Christ said. And she said, "True, Lord." She acknowledged. What's your name, by the way?
Jamal.
She acknowledged. "Truth, Lord. Yes, I am a dog." Watch this. "Yet the dogs eat of the crumbs which fall from their master's table." Look at that word. From their what? From their masters. Christ is the master, right? Look at the word in this scripture. "And she said, Truth, Lord, yet the dogs eat of the crumbs which fall from their masters." Masters. That's plural. More than one. Why didn't he say master? Singular. Why would he say plural?
Bring it up.
Why would Christ say that?
Bring it up,
Dad. Because, look. Go to, hold that, Romans 8. Joint heirs with Christ. Romans 8 and 17. I'm going to show you something, Jamal. I'm going to show you something too, sis. Because a lot of people say Israelites, they don't like black women. Oh, we do love black women. Because when the black woman comes where we are, they learn how to love their children. They learn how to, guess what? Respect their husbands.
That's
you know why a lot of brothers don't marry black women? Because they're loud.
Right.
They don't know how to keep their mouth closed. Oh, that's the truth, isn't it? That's the truth. We gotta tell you the truth. Read this now.
The book of Romans, chapter 8, and verse 17.
Listen to this.
And if children, then heirs.
The Bible says, and if children, because we are children, we're children of God. And if children, Jamal, watch this.
And if children, then heirs.
Then heirs. An heir, Jamal, is when you have a child. And before you die, you leave an inheritance. He's your heir. Like somebody said, you're heir to the throne, meaning it's your right, your claim. The Bible says that if we're children, then we're heirs. Come on.
Heirs of God and joint heirs with Christ.
And joint heirs with Christ. What does that mean to be joint heirs with Christ? Meaning what? We will rule. The Bible says, I'm going to show you something. Get Deuteronomy chapter 7. Deuteronomy chapter 7 and verse 6. The Bible is teaching us how we are to conduct ourselves. The Bible is teaching us who we are. We are the Israelites according to the Bible. Deuteronomy 7 and 6. Read this.
The book of Deuteronomy chapter 7 and verse 6.
Come on.
For thou art an holy people.
The Bible says, for thou. It didn't say all people. It said, for thou, you are in holy people. You never heard that. You never heard that. You heard everybody's holy. You heard everybody's a child of God.
What?
You heard we all equal.
Right.
We ain't all equal.
That's right.
We not all equal.
Right.
You know what the proof is? You can't buy homes in any kind of area.
Right.
Why? Because you don't got the right skin complexion.
Right.
So when you hear, oh, we equal to all the people. Really? So why the hell did Flint get poisoned with lead water?
Bring it out.
If we all equal, why was it Flint that got the lead poison in their water?
Jesus.
Why? Because the nations hate black people.
That's
they
right.
hate us. Why? Because we are the sons of the living God.
That's right.
Read this now.
For thou art an holy people.
Moses didn't say everybody. He said, for thou, you, we,
unto the Lord thy God.
Come on.
The Lord thy God hath chosen thee.
He didn't say he chose everybody. everybody. He said he chose thee. You. That ain't everybody. That means there's something special about you and not the other people.
Right.
You understand? We, the Lord thy God, have chosen thee to be a special people. The Bible now says that black people are a special people.
That's right.
That's why we're always kept on the bottom. Because it's the rise of blacks and Hispanics that everybody fears. It's the rise of blacks and Hispanics. Come on. A special people unto himself. Now watch what the Bible says. What's your name, by the way?
Tracy.
Tracy, watch what he's about to say. Above. What? Above. What? Above. Above all people that are on the face of the earth. Guess what? We never heard that. We never heard that we are above all people. We heard we are equal. Really? If black people are equal to everybody, why are we always on the bottom?
Right.
If we're equal to everybody, why are we always on the bottom?
Yeah.
We've been to the projects in Chicago, right, and Baltimore.
Right.
Everywhere you go is drug dealing.
Right.
But this is a different breed of black men. Flint, Michigan, you never seen black men like this.
That's right.
Read this now. Get Hosea chapter 4 and verse 6. Hosea chapter 4 verse 6. The Bible is going to explain to us, why are we always in the bottom? Why are we always the last high first fight? Why are there always problems in our communities? Hosea 4 and 6.
This is the book of Hosea chapter 4 and verse 6. My people are destroyed.
He says my people are destroyed. How are we destroyed? I'm going to show you how we're destroyed. We're destroyed by this. Get Deuteronomy 22 and verse 22. How are we destroyed as a people? How? What makes black people destroyed? We're not going to tell you a feel-good message. We're going to tell you the truth.
That's
the
right.
Truth is we got to keep God's commandments.
That's right.
This is how we're destroyed. Read this.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 22 and verse 22.
You know?
If a man be found lying with a woman married.
If a man be found having sex with a woman that is married.
So if a man be found lying with a woman married to a husband, then they both, then they shall both of them die.
That's called adultery. You don't know that there's a lot of black women that go sleeping around? That there's a lot of black men that go sleeping around?
Right.
That's adultery.
That's
what's
right.
The judgment? Disease. Read that verse again.
If a man be found lying with a woman married to a husband.
That doesn't happen in our neighborhoods? Of course it does. That's how some of us were born, through adultery. That's how some of us were born. The Bible is reading our spirits. Why? Because we're the people of the Bible. This is us. I'm going to show you something. Get Matthew. Matthew chapter 1 and verse 21. Let's see what Jesus Christ said. Matthew 1 and verse 21. Read this.
The book of Matthew, chapter 1 and verse 21. And she shall bring forth a son.
This is Mary, Christ's mother, a black woman.
Read. And thou shalt call his name Jesus.
And his name shall be called Jesus. Why?
For he shall save his people from their sins.
For he shall save his people from their sins. One of the sins? Adultery. That's one of the sins. We thought it's all right to just have sex with multiple women. God says that's wicked as hell. And that's how you spread disease in the neighborhood.
Right.
You keep sleeping around with different women, one of them is going to give you herpes. One of them is going to give you chlamydia. One of them is going to give you HIV. And then it spreads like fire.
That's right.
This is God's laws we read it. The solution to our problem is keep God's commandments.
That's right.
Deuteronomy 28 verse 61. When you sleep around with multiple women, when a woman sleeps around with multiple men, I'm going to show you the love of Jesus right now. You want to know what the love of Jesus is? We're going to read it to you.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28 and verse 61. Also, every sickness, we, and every plague, we, with
not in the Bible. General herpes is not in the Bible. We feel them, those diseases, will the Lord bring upon thee. Why would the Lord bring that disease upon you? For sleeping around with multiple sex partners. So who brings diseases? The Lord of heaven and earth. The Lord of heaven and earth. That's why we are hitting the streets, because this is what's going to change black people. Read it again. Also, every sickness and every plague, which is not written in the book of this law, them will the Lord bring upon thee until thou be destroyed. Now, is there repentance? Yes. Of course there's repentance. It don't mean you get chlamydia disease, that's it. You can still change your life. You can still change your life. Get Matthew. Let's get the book of Matthew, chapter 3 and verse 3. No, John chapter 3 and verse 3. John chapter 3 and verse 3. Read this.
The book of John, chapter 3 and verse 3.
Read it out.
Jesus answered and said unto him, verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born again.
Except a man or woman be born again, mean change your life,
he cannot see the kingdom of God.
The kingdom of God is what? What is the kingdom of God? We think the kingdom of God belongs to the whole world. It don't. That's the truth of the Bible. We thought the kingdom of God belongs to the entire world. It's not. The secret is the kingdom of God is going to be prepared. And the kingdom of God, who's going to rule? Who will rule in God's kingdom? Blacks and Hispanics. It will be a new world order. It will be a new world order. Everything will be done in righteousness. Everything.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold, from Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.